Let's step inside. There's a shop. A little diesel I'm working on there. Here's the beast. Propane fired. I will get that hose off there so we can get a little closer look at the boiler. Came with a little engine, a little upright engine on it. I'm yet to identify that engine. And yet a smaller, little tiny engine down here. And an oiler. So we'll get it up here on the table and get a closer look at it here soon. Okay, I'm back. We've got it on the got it put up on the lift table here where I can get it up and take a look at it without having to stoop over. Kind of an overview here. I've been looking for a small boiler to run Kreeter's style engines. I've got a few of those type engines that I'm looking to run. Matter of fact, here's a little Kreeter's over here I picked up at the same place. It's fun to run them on air. I understand all that, but I also want to run them off steam. So I've been looking for a boiler and finally found one. And I'll give a quick overview of it here. This is as found. It's not set up like I want to eventually have it, but hey, nonetheless, here it is. It's gas fired. Here's a gas burner and piping down here at the very bottom. It looks a little rough all over, but it's old. My gosh, I don't know what the age is on it. It's an old boiler. So that's all I can say at this point. I know that this is against the rules, but I just wanted to initially put a little air in it and see just how many leaks it has. And so I put a fitting on here, and this is the blowdown valve and also where you can fill the boiler. I'll put a hose fitting on that eventually so I can fill it with a hose. It holds air. The actual pressure vessel holds air. Now it has a few leaks externally on some of these fittings. It holds. That's promising. I will have it tested. I'm going to get a hold of some guys that know more about this than I, and I want to have it hydro tested. I don't want to blow myself or anybody else up. So, but initially, I put 40 pounds of air in it, and it works. The whistle blows, and the engine, little engine over here, tries to run, but it's pretty rough. It needs a total restore, so I'm going to do that. But anyway, back to the boiler. Quick overview. It's sitting on a homemade frame here. It looks like this might be an old garden tractor frame or something like that. It's got steel casters on it under here, and which is fine. It's got a swiveler up here, a crazy wheel or a steerable wheel. It's got a set of lawnmower handles on here to handle it with. Let me walk over here a little bit. Here's a view from this end. It is the dimensions. The pressure vessel is 9 inches in diameter and about 30 inches tall, if I recall. It's just a perfect size for these little engines that I want to play with. And I want to play with some whistles. And so I'm going to put some fittings on there and put some different whistles on it occasionally. But let's go through it here. Inside the smoke box, now I don't know, we'll take a look down the smoke pipe here. I don't know if you'll be able to see anything or not, but anyway, the flues, it's got several flues. I haven't counted them yet, but it's got a few flues in there. And the steam pipe comes right up in the center. of the flues. And it tees. One side of it comes out this side and goes down to the engines. The other side comes out here, feeds the whistle, and feeds the injector. And so that's nice. I got lots of options here to put accessories and different things on it. And I'm going to plumb up some tees on it and try to be able to steam several different things. So anyway, over on this side, coming out of the boiler to a whistle. Pretty nice little whistle, loud little booger. Had it on air there a while ago, and definitely will get your attention. Okay, we come down to a valve where we can shut off the steam supply to the Penberthy injector. And this is water in here. It comes out of this tube, this pipe here. It's got he's got a screen on it here where he sticks it down in a bucket of water. And that's where we're going to feed the boiler when it's under steam. It's fresh water. Now I want to also put a mechanical pump on it so I can pump it quickly if I have to, if the water level drops. And eventually I want to do that. The nice thing about it is it's gas fired, and if you get into a situation you can just turn the flame off and stop the building of pressure. It's got two tricocks on it. There's one missing up here. He's got it plugged off. They're not in the best condition. They seem to be locked up. I didn't try to open them. So I'll probably either rebuild them or replace them or find another tricock to put up here. I want it to look like it's all here and all nice and functional. They are just what they say. You open them up and see where your water level is. If something would happen to your gauge glass. Here's the gauge, and the glass is in good shape, and it's got a drain down here. You can drain the gas or the glass down, blow your glass down, clean it, and be able to monitor your water level. And we'll walk on around here. We've got another plug up here, up at the top, that could be tapped into. We have what appears to be a fusible plug here at the bottom. And then down to the very bottom, we've got clean-out plugs every 90 degrees around the boiler. And here's the burner housing here. And I'm going to take this all apart and see how the burner operates, see if it needs cleaned. Here's the hole where you light it. And let's see, coming down from the injector, back to the injector side here. Coming down here into the check valve, that check valve's leaking air a little bit. I don't think these things are made to be completely sealed up. They're always going to be leaky, steamy, just a little leakage here and there. But I want to get it off the burner base and inspect the bottom of it, kind of examine that, make sure the flues and tap around on the bottom flue plate, make sure that it's the flue sheet, make sure that it's solid. And also I want to have it apart so we can examine it when it's hydro tested. So I'll have everything off of it to hydro test it. And on this side now, we've got, let me walk around to the other side here, we can see the gauge. We come out of this side to the pop-off valve, pressure release valve. And then we have a gauge, and it's got a nice brass face on it. That'll polish up real nice. Cast iron back on it. It's got the loop in it here to keep the steam from touching the element inside the gauge. And there's a T at that point. You can T something else into it, another engine or whatever. Then we've got the valve, the main valve shut off to the engine. And we come down to where he's got the engines plumbed in. And we've got a Manzel oiler on here. Kind of overkill for these little engines, but it's cool nonetheless. I was told by the fella I bought it from that he had another engine mounted up here in the front and had it hooked up to this linkage, and the linkage would operate the oiler. And again, something interesting to watch while this thing's running. So I don't know if I'll use that or not, or just use displacement oilers on it. I don't know exactly what I'm going to do at this point. But this oiler is nice. It's got a sight glass there for the main oil supply. It's got a sight glass up here where you can watch the actual drip. And it's got oil in it. You pull this lid off and it's got a screen there. You can pull it out to clean it. And let me get a shot of the tag. That's the only tag on the whole outfit, I think, other than some data stamped on the valve here. It has some data on it too, and I'll check that out later. But anyway, that's the oiler. Here is the little engine. I need to identify this engine. I don't recognize it, so I'll get it ID'd. It does look like a nice little engine. It should clean up pretty nice. It's got a nice little strap there on its rod. Don't know about the flywheel, if it's original or not to the engine, especially since it's got this little casting bump on it here. Not sure what's going on there. And somebody's kind of made a bushing out of a piece of pipe to get that flywheel on there, so I'm not sure that's the original flywheel. And then here appears to be a little homemade engine. And it's pretty cool. It's got a little reversing lever on it. Little Stevenson reversing mechanism on it here. I'll clean it up and get it running too. So that's about it. Blowdown valve. And it appeared to be a little rough at the bottom, but I think it's just crud and junk on there. There's some surface rust. But we'll take a look and see what has to be done to it. It's promising because it holds air, so. And being as small as it is, I don't think it's going to be all that dangerous to operate. And I don't expect to run it much over. Probably much over 60 pounds. He told me the pop-off was set at 80. But I don't know. It's all to be tested later on. It does have an inspector's tag, what appears to be an inspector's tag on it here. I don't know what any of it means. It come out of Iowa. So I'm not sure what this means. But I will find out. B&H 43375 NB 37431. And the brass tag on here says 1684. Don't know. Anxious to learn. But anyway, that's the overview. It's going to get completely disassembled, unplumbed, hydro tested, reassembled in the configuration that I like a little bit better than this. and go from there.